Many ask for something honest, loving heart with someone new. And love, only thing that's promised love to my heart, the only thing that's hard love to embrace, only thing that makes life worth living. Seems love is here to stay. Seems love is here to stay.
My name is N'Dea Davenport. I am a creative, very, very creative person. It's kind of funny because out of that creativity, I think from the beginning when I was a kid, for years, I actually was very, very embarrassed about like having an odd name like N'Dea and Davenport. I've always kind of cheered for the underdog in some respects because it's like the odd bald or the odd man or woman out coming from bases in music, dance, music studies, athletics, kind of one of these kids that just really needed to like get involved in anything possible to try to stay out of trouble, which I think I did a pretty decent job of that. Through that, it's actually like built me in my own kind of like bubble or my own headspace about like how I approach life. And I'm just a person that loves to create and be in creative situations with people that like to do that too. New York City really experienced a lot of pain and suffering with the situations with 9/11. I also had a residence down in New Orleans, Louisiana. Those two have really helped to kind of shape and form my perspective on life in such a unique way. I literally had to shut down my creative process and my living, my lifestyle, and basically start over. There's a sense of loss that sometimes can also be like a very inspirational thing. Sometimes those trying experiences, I tend to get a lot of inspiration from that, a lot of clarity, prioritizing those types of things and really building bridges, not burning bridges. Those are the things that I'm definitely much more in touch with that I've been trying to aspire to, expressing that through music. Creatively, those types of situations really kind of helped me to be able to bring my creative level to where I'd like it to be. My creative process goes in several different directions. It really depends on who I'm collaborating with or if I'm doing things personally. My favorite thing to do is actually collaborate with people. I absolutely love that. So right now I'm doing a lot of collaborating with people via cyberspace, sending tracks back and forth. Unfortunately, because I'm traveling all the time, I can actually go and get with them and record a track. I'm much more of a rhythmic person. Rhythm, bass, and drums are like my backbone, a lot of times how I like to create. If it's done from scratch, we'll just like completely start off the bone, just bring it on up to whatever the song is gonna eventually evolve to be. For those of you that don't know, I rejoined forces with my former band members, the Brand New Heavies. My strongest assets for sure would be songwriter, melody, arrangement. It really depends on what the process is. I can kind of go any direction. If someone has an idea about a track and they give me the basics of it and I can take it and create. Like I said, I have a very vivid imagination. I really apply everything to life, how you're in the flow of things. My approach to actually singing, it's almost not really like acting, but it's almost like just expressing an emotion. We as performers, we have certain duties that we are responsible to do as far as sharing music and sharing emotion with people. And so many different people have like come up to me and said, hey, you know, that song got me through this, that got me through college, I almost committed suicide, I almost did this, and that helped to take me over. When I'm actually performing or doing something vocally, I really like to be 100% in the moment, to be able to have the clarity with the audience and us having this type of response and being able to like emote a feeling. And it's really important, I think, to do that. It's a blessing that I have the opportunity to be able to do it, and this is my career, and that I love it so much, and I love being able to share it with people. Like in anything, and like nothing's perfect. I go off key sometimes. It's like a craft that you continuously try to make better. Just like anything, it's like an instrument. I'm just a human instrument. I approach it that way. I want to share with everybody a situation that is affecting so many women right now. Initially, it was affecting more women of color, but now it's sort of like branching out to so many other types of women from different backgrounds. The topic is uterine fibroids. And uterine fibroids are basically these tumors that are affecting women, affecting their health, affecting their abilities to have children. There's been a lot of questions about, you know, the medical situations that we're dealing with, the doctors. I mean, is it necessary for you to take all these medicines? A lot of these doctors, they basically tell a woman that they need to cut out their uterus. That is absolutely the absolute wrong way to actually deal with this particular condition. These symptoms of having uterine fibroids, they can be very, very extreme. Your body basically just does not function. There's a lot of blood loss. I actually will share with you that I actually did suffer with that condition. Just recently, I actually dealt with that condition. It took about 10 years to actually find a doctor that would want to absolutely preserve the uterus. And I encourage any woman at this point in time, please, please take your time. Find a great doctor that will want to preserve your uterus. I was embarrassed about it for a really, really long time. You see some pictures of me from like back in the day, like about 10, 11 years ago, and I look a little bit swollen. The big part because as a result of that particular condition. So please don't take your health lightly. I'm on a completely amazing page to recovery, and life has just shown me a whole nother side of what it can be like. But take care of yourself, take care of your body, and always take care of who you are and deal with that. Peace.
Many ask for something honest, loving heart with someone new. And love, only thing that's promised love. To my heart, the only thing that's hard love. To embrace, only thing that makes life worth living. Seems love is here to stay. Seems love is here to stay. I remember the first time love touched my heart. Memory of that day. Delicate touch, long, warm skin. Breeze sang softly, and I trembled beneath your touch. As I trembled.